At the age of 10, I was the thinnest boy in Tiberias. People used to say, Menachem, when he walks the streets, you don't see him. So I started to become kind of the joker of the class, to be funny, to tell stories. I decided to take some photos from the library of my mother, and I made a roller like a toilet paper. I started to prepare exciting stories that I invented based on this primitive cinema machine. I put little ads in the school that said that on Saturday morning at 10 o'clock will be a showing of a movie created by Menachem. Nobody came. So I thought, what shall I do to bring them to see my movie? And I then came up with an idea, and the idea is with me all my life. You must pay the audience. I put a new ad. Anybody who will come to see my movie will get a penny. And it was a full house.
אפשר לשבת?
כן, תודה רבה.
סתכל עליי, מנחם. מנחם, let me ask you, how do you become a filmmaker?
Don't do anything else. If you love movies, you want to be a movie maker, you have to give yourself to the movie. You have to forget your other life. You have to dream about the movie, steal the money, kill your aunt, take her money, make a movie.
זהו מנחם גולן, בימאי תיאטרון צעיר שבימים אלו פורץ לזירה הקולנועית עם סרטו הראשון אלדורדו.
אתה משחק את זה בצרפתית, אתה הולך מפה ואתה עובר לצד שני כשאני
בנת
אותי.
גולן טוען כי הוא אינו מעוניין לעשות אומנות וכי אלוהיו האמיתי הוא הקהל. הוא רוצה לעשות קולנוע ממש כמו בהוליווד. כינור דוד, פרס האוסקר הישראלי, הוענק השנה לבימאי הקולנוע מנחם גולן, שזכה בפרס בשל בימוי אלדורדו, ומבטיח כי אתם עוד תשמעו עליו.
One day I got a call from Uncle Shmulik, Yoram's father. Menachem, can you help me with Yoram? He doesn't want to go to school. He sits in the box office and sells tickets. Yoram is my cousin, my first cousin. So I said, you know what, send him to me to Tel Aviv and I'll see what I can do.
Okay. We start again.
Yeah. I actually would like to start from the beginning.
From the beginning?
Yeah, I want to know how it all started for you.
In age of 3, my father built a cinema and that's probably was my fate. Because since I remember myself, I was going to hang posters, and in the age of 6, 7, I was already a cashier. Every Friday, it used to be in the newspaper, big boxes with a picture of every movie. I used to cut it, divide it to companies, and sell to myself. I played with it, like somebody played Monopoly, I played selling movies. And guess what? Always I made money.
And Yoram arrived in Tel Aviv.
He started working with me at my company, Noah Films. Back then, I was producing Sarah Shabbati. And I gave Yoram the job of distributing it.
I felt that he will master distribution by instinct.
To work in somebody that was your hobby, to get it as a job, well, you cannot ask for better.
אני זוכר דבר אחד. הקרנו, הקרנה ניסיונית.
לחברים שלנו, על אנשים מהתעשייה.
עומד קישון, עומד יורם, אני חוזים בסרט, שקט. קישון, דמעות מתחילות לזול מעיניו.
הוא אומר, הם לא צוחקים. הם לא צוחקים.
אמרתי, סבלנות. בוא ננסה את זה על קהל האמיתי. הסרט נפתח בקולנוע הוד. ברגע שהסרט התחיל, התחילו שעגות צחוק. ועשינו את הסרט הראשון שהיה מועמד לאוסקר.
בעקבות הצלחת סרטו סלח שבתי, הבימאי מנחם גולן עובד לימים אלו על סרט חדש. הפעם מדובר בסרט הוליוודי דובר אנגלית עם כוכבים גדולים מאמריקה. זהו מבצע קהיר.
Then Menachem produced a picture called Frank to Cairo. And he did a co-production deal in North America for almost nothing, for $75,000. And the picture cost, I think, over $1 million. And I said, how are you going to recover it?
The mistake was that we shot the film in English. Even the Israeli actors, instead of speaking Hebrew, spoke English.
Come on, Gabon. Tomorrow is another day.
And you know, take an Israeli actor who speaks English, he speaks Pinglish. You know what is Pinglish?
Grab them!
This movie was a disaster, a flop.
Amen.
For us, it was the first movie that we lost money on.
תגידי לי, איך קוראים לך?
תנחס.
לא יודע, נו.
לא, תשים שם ככה.
אסתר.
לא.
מיריאם. מזל.
לא.
טוב, נו, לא, אני לא יודע.
לא הייתי בלהקה שקראו לה להקת פיקוד דיזנגוף. ובסוף ההצגה, עולה מנחם גולן, ואומר לי,
איתך אני אעשה סרט.
אמרתי לו, טוב.
לא פה. תבוא אליהם אחר למשרד.
ואני נכנס למשרד כל כולי רעדה. ואני רואה שיש איזה צו עיכול על כל מה שקורה במשרד. ואני תופס את מנחם בשיחת טלפון עם אשתו.
רחל, רחל, תרגי. את הרדיו תעבירי לשכנים, זה הכל.
My wife, I almost got a divorce. Are you kidding? I sold my house 3 times. Once I sold my fridge, it's true. But if you ask me, if I need to sell my apartment to do White Flags, I will. But I don't have an apartment anymore.
אין לכם אולי משהו יותר בזול?
זה הכי זול שיש.
I came to Menachem, and he was in trouble. I took all my savings since the bar mitzvah. I co-signed with him to the banks, and we became partners 50-50.
Mizrahi, yes, Elohim, v'shamayim. Mizrahi, yes, Elohim!
Then we started to do a series of mega hits. Nothing but money.
קצב הפקת סרטי עלילה התגבר לאחרונה. מנחם גולן עוסק עתה בצילום סרט.
בתל אביב נערכה הצגת הבכורה של הסרט הישראלי החדש, שמונה בעקבות אחד בבימויו של מנחם גולן.
סרטו של מנחם גולן, מרגו שלי.
הצגת הבכורה העולמית של דליה והמלאפים.
טוביה ושבע בנותה. הפריצה הגדולה. התקיימה בקולנוע חן בירושלים הצגת הבכורה החגיגית של הסרט הישראלי.
שושנה.
אני הצעתי אתמול שנתגרש.
יתנו.
רעיון נפלא גורדה.
Escaped? An Israeli? No one escapes from my prison.
Is that a fact?
That is a fact.
Thank you.
ולא מוכן לוותר?
הוא לא, תראה, הוא צריך ש... מה זה לוותר? הוא צריך שמייק ייתן לו, יעני, ביטור.
אני בחרתי את הפרויקטים, ויורם היה איש הכספים, והוא ביצע את התפקיד שלו בצורה מושלמת. הייתי גאה בו, ללא ספק הייתי גאה בו.
Working with Menachem at that time, of course, he was the big dad, and I was the child. That for him, it stayed forever. He didn't accept it that, you know, I grew up.
מה אתה דואג?
הם השלימו אחד את השני. באמת, גם בשיחה היומיומית שהם היו ביחד והם היו מדברים על מישהו, אז הם תמיד היו משלימים אחד את השני, וזה היה משהו, איזה רכבת שאי אפשר לעצור אותה.
There is no accounting between us. There's never been, never been. From the first day we've been together, never been. It's more than brothers. We forge each other's signatures on checks.
יורם ואבא שלי היו בעל ואישה. נקודה. להכל. להכל. אם זה קנה שברולט כחול, זה קנה שברולט ירוק. אני לא ראיתי הפרדה. אני לא ראיתי שהוא יכול בלעדיו או שהוא יכול בלעדיו, ולא משנה מה.
הלילה זה הלילה, כולנו מסוגים.
עכשיו קצת שקט ותקשיבו להגדה. עבדים היינו לפרעו במצרים, ויציאנו אדוני אלוהינו משם ביד חזקה ובזרוע נטויה. בייחוד הילדים צריכים לשמוע את הסיפור הזה. ואם הוא לא הוציא הקדוש...
האג'נט של ג'יימס קופרון, נו.
אני אצלצל, קח מספר.
אי אפשר, נו, צריך לדבר איתך, אז חכה.
נו, מה אני יכול לעשות?
נו, עשה הפסקה, אתה באמצע הסדר.
אני באמצע הסדר.
תתנצל, תגיד לו
שם. היית ביזנס באמצע הסדר, כזה דבר עוד
לא קרה. היה ביניהם איזה מין שיתוף פעולה של האיש הטוב והאיש הרע. מנחם היה אומר, אוקיי, מה שאתה רוצה, ויורם היה אומר, לא, מה פתאום, מה אתה, למה, לא, אנחנו צריכים להוריד. מנחם אומר, כן, אני אוהב אותו, ואני רוצה לתת לו, ואני מסתכל על הפימפונג הזה, ואני יודע שהם תכננו כבר מראש כמה לתת, ואיך זה ישולם.
הקסבה בחצי היום כשהשוק פתוח, הייתי ככה סתם הולך והחזם...
זוכר בקזבלן, ביום מסוים, מנחם הביא המון אנשים לשיר גדול, כולנו יהודים, הוא הביא... המון המון בני נוער, ואז הוא אמר, תשמע, יציקו לך בוודאי, ויבואו וירצו חתימות, יש קרוון, אתה יושב בקרוון, אתה שומע את האוברטורה, ברגע שנשמע את האוברטורה, צא החוצה ונתחיל. וכך היה. ואני יוצא החוצה ואני עובר בין מאות ילדים, אף אחד אפילו לא מכבד אותי במבט. אף אחד, מין מבט כזה זגוגי. חשבתי אולי הוא אילף אותם, אולי הוא יפחיד אותם עם השאגות שלו. לא?
שקט כאן!
הוא הביא שלושה בתי ספר של ערבים מיפו, שהם עם כל הכבוד, לא כך יודעים מי זה יורם גאון, לא כך עניין אותם, והם כולם שרו, כולנו יהודים, וכל כך נחמדים.
כולנו יהודים, וכל כך נחמדים, יהודים הם 100%, גם השבצה וגם הבוסקון.
זכי קדימה.
They were known for the industry. You have to make it big, bigger than life, the same way that you do it here. They were the Israeli Hollywood.
We used to go, Boaz and me, at 3 o'clock in the morning, shouting and waking up people, Eskimo Limon, Lemon Popsicle, what a movie, what a movie. And our crews, an actor, used to look at Boaz at me like we are crazy.
All now! See? About the civilization, take a hat.
Olika! After we finished the film, we went to the Milan Film Market to try to sell it all over the world.
The auditorium was sold out. And suddenly, in the middle, people starting to walk out. I wanted to cry. I said, how come? In Israel is such a success. Well, people don't like my movie. Was that crazy? The bottom line, they walk away in the middle of the movie to buy the movie, that the competitor will not beat them.
Große Packung Gummis besorgt. Lass das bloß keinen sehen. Hey, Nili.
Was denn?
Hast du schon einen festen Freund?
כל הזמן אמרו, אתם לא תוכלו לעבור ברחוב. נדמה לי שיורם היה אומר לה, אתה לא תוכל לעבור ברחוב. והוא צדק.
אלן ביד, אבז, שלאורך השנים מטיל ביצי זהב.
Darf ich fragen, was Sie da treiben?
Mir ist der Mayonnaise-Sandwich für die junge Dame runtergefallen und den rubbel
ich... The success of this movie, in many ways, was the bridge to America.
And now let's all get serious.
We thought that we reached the top. And we are filmmakers, so we wanted to elevate ourselves and to do something differently. And then we decide to leave Israel to find our way in America.
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Micha, how are you?
Good, Menachem?
Yes.
How are you?
Good, very good.
Well, I'm in Los Angeles now.
Ah, you are in Los Angeles, so I don't have to shout.
I mean,
can I help you?
I give my word of honor.
Okay, I trust you. A handshake with us is like a contract.
The name of the picture, the name, you have a name?
We have a name. Screwing around.
Eh?
Screwing around.
Screwing?
Screwing, screwing. You know what is screwing?
Screwing?
Screwing. S like Sarah. C R E.
Yeah.
W-I-N-G, screwing.
That is fucking. Screwing is fucking.
Victor!
Yes?
It's Yoram.
You bastard. You're a big bastard.
Where is my money? You promise and promise and promise and you're not paying.
If I don't keep my word, then you don't speak to me again.
But it's finished.
At that time, it was illegal to take money out of Israel. So we flew to America with $500 in our pockets. We shared a small apartment and lived like roommates. We ate sausages every day, and we worked from a small office in the worst neighborhood in Los Angeles. It wasn't very glamorous, but it was the best time of our lives.
It's all the time. Keep suspense and action. Sinister voices. You know, add to it. No music here. Here, hold it. Again, gentlemen, we are going to get some action.
If there is a hell on earth, it's inside these walls.
Meet Israeli duo Menachem Golan and Yoram Globus. They have a dream of taking over Hollywood with their company Canon Films. And what kind of movies do they make? Some critics call them schlock films. But actually, they're just plain low-budget movies.
Did you ever make a $30 million movie?
Never. I don't know what to do with 30 million. I can make 30 movies, maybe, you know? But I don't know what to do with 30 million. I mean, I'll feel like I'm a criminal spending this kind of money on doing one motion picture.
Not all what I wanted is done. And I still have goals to achieve a motion picture that will be a world hit. When I did a successful motion picture in Israel, I went to the theater, a full house, when people were fighting to get in, and I didn't get that yet here in America. And I probably won't get it so soon. I won't get it until I'll make a real American movie that they could identify with. And not being an American, that's not easy. But I'll do it.
In 1994, the world is controlled by one power.
Apple is a movie I directed about the hippies. When we started to do it, we think that the music is very new. And we loved it.
We loved the story, we liked the color of the movie, and we thought that it will conquer the world.
When we finished it, it was chosen to Montreal Festival as an opener. In the opening night, in the middle of the movie, people left the theater and kind of booed the movie.
This was our biggest fiasco.
He got me with my back against the wall.
And Menachem said to me, I'm going to the toilet. After 10 minutes, Menachem doesn't come. I said to our people, let's go and find him.
I went up to the 8th floor. And I stood in the balcony and wanted to kill myself, wanted to jump out. And it was Yoram who chased me. Yoram held me and he said to me, Menachem, there will be other movies. יום אחד הבת שלי אומרת לי, אבא, אתה לא יודע מה שנעשה בחוף הים. הנוער רוקד ריקוד שלא ראית כזה דבר. וזה כובש מיום ליום, יותר קל ויותר קל ויותר קל. אני אמרתי, נעשה על זה סרט.
So we said, we are going to do a movie and we have to do it fast. Because if we will not do it fast, somebody else will do it for us. So how can you do it fast? With Israelis.
2 בלילה, אני מקבל טלפון פה. אחרי שלא דיברתי איתו כמה שנים. יש, אתה יודע, היי, מה נשמע? הערתי אותך, שום דבר. יואל, המשפט הראשון. יואל, אתה יודע מה זה ברייק דנסינג? אני אומר, זה החבר'ה האלה שמסתובבים על הראש, אומר, כן, בדיוק, תעלה על מטוס ותבוא. הגעתי ללוס אנג'לס, לוקחים אותי במונית ישר לאיזה סטודיו, איזה 50 חבר'ה, שחורים ופורטוריקנים, עם רמקולים בגודל של הדלת הזאת, רעש אימים, מרביצים, ג'ייבים, כזה. אני אומר, יואל, לאן נפלת? מה אני עושה פה?
The normal 16-week shooting schedule for an average film was cut to an unheard of 3 weeks. All the tensions and pressures that come with making a motion picture were intensified. Joel Zilberg faced a rigorous shooting schedule.
The picture is being edited right now in Los Angeles while I'm still shooting, and by the time I get to Los Angeles in a week's time, the picture will be cut.
This scene, I'm telling you, this is a new dance. This will grab the whole world. Go and tell
your peers. MGM, שאז הפיצה לנו סרטים, אנחנו עשינו את הקרנה באולם הגדול שלהם. בסוף הסרט אני מסתכל עליהם, חצי ישנים.
We seem to have a problem here.
But I'm very much afraid they won't be able to dance for us.
And why not?
It's a Schwarze movie, כך אמרו לי. It's a Schwarze movie.
And we would know that we have to open it in America fast. So I said to them, you know something? I will guarantee the distribution. If you lose on distribution, I will pay. They said, ha-ha, okay. But I said, but you take half of your percentages.
Breakdancing is breaking out in some of the unlikeliest surroundings.
Shabadoo and Boogaloo Shrimp came all the way from America to break dance for the folks in Cannes.
This is a film that Canon did, started only 12 weeks ago, and it's already in the theaters.
Movie fans have been high-stepping it to the box office, where Breakin' has grossed $18.5 million since it opened less than 3 weeks ago.
You can all get rich in this business.
This year, the big hit for Golan and Globus is Breakin'. It cost just over $1 million to make and has so far taken in more than $56 million.
The picture did in America almost $100 million. No, which is crazy. The picture cost $1 million too.
Don't be mistaken, you've got to see Break It.
This is the Hollywood that most people know and love. the fancy cars, exclusive restaurants, and the lavish homes. Golan and Globus will have nothing to do with this. They run their company like a factory, a no-frills operation where long hours and low pay are the norm.
We are not the kind of people of Mamaison or Jimmy's, you know, the fancy, expensive restaurant. We are not this kind.
What, do you eat sandwiches here?
We are eating sandwiches.
Yes, here. Believe
that's true, believe yes. it or not. We are eating sandwiches in our offices every lunch.
I think you're going to be surprised at how anxious the networks would be to do business with you.
The main thing is not to hesitate and to go and be able to take chances.
99% of the budget of a picture is going to the screen. Not with all the limousine, schmilmousine, lunches, bunches. We don't have time for this. On this time that Menachem is spending few lunches, he can do another picture.
הולך להחליף את המוזיקה, אני הולך לשנות קצת, אני מחפש שם. בינתיים יש לי איזה שם, אני צריך שאתה מתה תחשוב עליו. Stop that marriage. בינתיים, זה השם שלי בינתיים.
היה הולידי עם רום.
הולידי עם רום, הולידי עם וניס. מריג' אין
וניס.
מריג' אין וניס.
זה לא...
זה שם טוב.
כן?
כן. מריג' אין וניס. או Stop that marriage.
כן, כן.
מריג' אין וניס.
Are we getting lunch here?
I was sitting with my wife in a French restaurant, and here comes one of the waiters, a handsome young man, holding two plates of soup. And he says to me in French, "Vous êtes Monsieur Golan?" I said, "Yes, I'm Golan." He picked up his foot, right foot, and he rubbed my head. The soup did not move.
I kick above his head, and he gave me, "My friend, tomorrow, come to my office, we'll talk you and I business." And I go to his office, and I try to provoke some sorts of dialogue. And I took my shirt, my jacket, and I show, "I've got muscle. I can do the split." So I take a chair, I pull back for the vision, I go, "Oh, in a split position. I can be a fighter, karate, everything for free." He said, "Bam, bam. Maybe I gave too much." Sit down. Michael Dudakov is a star. What can I do with the split? The muscle. I need acting. Sorry. Like, oh, Menachem, please, may not get to... I was like... I break down. And he looked at me like with his big heart. Like, don't go. Don't go next to me like this. Sit down, sit down. Okay. And he see me, "I'm so sorry. I'm sorry if I cry. I'm so fucking sorry." And then he think, and he think, "Karin, bring me Bloodsport." And she come, and he go, "You want to be a movie star? I'm gonna make you a movie star."
Budget, highly commercial action films are canon stock in trade. Critics call them exploitation movies, pandering to the lowest cinematic taste.
Canon was my favorite film company as a kid. When we saw that logo of those steel seas coming together, they were like, "Oh, it's a Canon movie. It's going to be awesome." You knew there was going to be guns. You knew there was going to be chicks. You knew there was nudity. There was violence. Canon was synonymous with awesome in the 80s. There was no other film label that did that.
Canon creates low-budget exploitation movies by the dozen, with simplistic plots and no doubt about who is good and who is bad.
I think the audience goes into my movies with a certain feeling of frustration. Even though it's entertainment and it's fantasy, when they leave the theater, there's a certain release, a certain feeling of something being done, even though it's done in a movie. Uh-huh. They can leave the theater feeling a little bit better than when they went into the theater, because the good guy does come out on top.
You can go to the movie theater and just watch the screen and veg out and forget about the problems you had that day, because this is just going to be a lot of fun to watch. And you're going to want to root for the good guy. and hope the bad guy gets what he gets. And he normally did. He normally did. And then you walk out and you say, I love that guy, don't you? Yeah, Bronson's cool.
Watching Chuck Norris go through a shopping mall on the hood of a car blasting people with Uzis, it was the most exciting and thrilling thing as a kid. The Russians were invading. There were ninjas everywhere. They were so much fun that as a 12, 13, 14-year-old, it's pure cinematic ecstasy watching these movies.
So, you are vowing to play chicken?
It's interesting, these Israeli guys came in and really took over American pop culture with these movies. Back then, movies were the only source for pop culture. There was no internet, there was no Facebook, there's no YouTube. You couldn't get stuff from anywhere. People would watch these movies over and over and over and imitate them because that was our only source of getting new culture. They brought us ninjas, Chuck Norris, Charles Bronson, and breakdancing. I think that a lot of the canon movies got dismissed as garbage or crap, and as a kid, that always offended me. As an adult, it offends me. You know, I went over to Tarantino's house. He's like, I got a 35mm print of Ninja 3, The Domination, and we watched it on 35 in his theater, and this is like the best director in the world still appreciating this movie.
This is Cannes, home of the prestigious film festival, which is held every year. You know about the glamour, the Riviera, the stars, but there's another side, a business side you don't see. Producers from around the world come here to set up shop and sell their product to motion picture distributors from around the world. That's where the Golan and Globus brainstorm came in. They've been so successful at it that all they have to do is announce plans for a movie and then wait in their hotel room for the money to come in.
They were experts at financing it, selling it, and then making it. They were selling before and then making after. And it worked. It really did work.
Tell me, the Stallone deal is set. I know, but is it completely signed?
We have a Machzara, 122. That was more than the first week. Yeah, more.
And you own the rest of the rights?
Yes.
So there is a possible ground to talk.
I will bring Svetis and Gina Holland to Tokyo.
I cannot allow a dialogue scene that will last more than a page.
Naked Face, you know, with Roger Moore.
It's a fantastic film for Argentina.
See?
Fantastic.
I'm your own Globus.
You're the, our president.
Sure. We sold a lot of pictures to India.
Oh, yeah? You used to go to Cannes with a finished movie. You showed it, then they bought it or didn't buy it. While I started to pre-license movies without them reading the script, without them knowing even what they're going to buy.
When we signed the stars, we took a session of photography to create a poster. The poster was more important than the movie. It came to a point that the distributor trusted that so much that I used to sell them for year to come 10 or 15 movies without titles even.
Les panneaux d'affichage qui envahissaient les devantures des grands hôtels, qui envahissaient la croisette, c'était Canon qui débarquait.
We all laughed at Menachem when he first came here from Israel 6 or 7 years ago, but he's become a big power. Canon Pictures make more films, have more influence, have more distributors, spend more money, and I must say, speaking personally and selfishly, he spends more money, my paper, than anybody rushes in every day and says, I want $10,000, I want, see, they're all, this is, he's mad, he spends fortunes, and he gets it back, so he must be doing something right.
There seem to be no lengths to which Canon will not go for publicity. The biggest publicity broadside of the entire festival so far was the arrival of this full-scale pirate galleon, which for the last year has been used for the filming of Roman Polanski's new movie, Pirates.
Pretty soon, after 2 years, people weren't calling it Cannes Film Festival, they were calling it the Canon Film Festival.
Canon is Menachem Golan and Yoram Globus.
Globus, with the beard, raises the cash. Golan spends it. 7 years ago, they paid $500,000 for Cannon. Today, it's worth $1,000,000 and is a worldwide force in every aspect of the film industry.
Very, very good to get good reviews on movies, but it's also important that the public will come to see your movies, because if they come, they will support you to do the next movie.
We must make a press conference now. Sit down.
One sentence in French. Pour moi, faire des films, c'est une grande histoire d'amour.
גולן הוא חלומו של הישראלי שעשה זאת, הצליח. ואולם, אם כבש את הוליווד ואת המוני הצופים באמריקה, לא כבש את לב המבקרים, לא בארצות הברית ולא בישראל. אלה כאלה ביקורתיים.
Gene Siskel and Roger Ebert of TV's At the Movies say Golan and Globus are not even true filmmakers, just shrewd salesmen.
They're deal makers. To date, they have not made what I would say is a really fine film.
After the new release by Cannon, the press has been pretty hostile. The language is filthy, the film is simple-minded, and Bronson's character has two weights, in gore and violence, exploiting hatred, fear, and manner. Results are every bit as revolting as in the original 1974 jackpot fantasy.
Let's have a look, just for a change, at some of the real stinkers of the year. Faced with one film at least, the critics rose up as one critic and blew a communal raspberry, and that was Bolero. Virgin on the ridiculous, The Guardian called it. Warmed up softcore porn it was, in which Miss Derrick spent most of her time revealing what we must now come to think of as her public parts.
וצוחקים, ובוכים, ומתרגשים, וקונים כרטיס, קונים כרטיס, כי הם רוצים לראות את הסרט שלך. ואני אוהב עוד דבר אחד, וזה האלוהים הגדול שלי, את מה שאני אעשה מחר.
If I speak to Altman and tell him...
אך ההצלחה הכלכלית לא מספקת את גולן, והוא רוצה אוסקר. מהפנטהאוס שלו לאחר יום צילומי מפרך, הוא מנהל שיחות טלפון טרנס-אטלנטיות עם יורם גלובוס, ומצליח לרתום שמות גדולים של הקולנוע העולמי אל העגלה שלו המושכת קדימה.
Do you know what's happening with the Godard, Jean-Luc Godard?
Despite their reputation as deal makers, Golan and Globus are also trying to make some so-called prestige films, like John Cassavetes's Love Stream.
I'm very proud of this. And I'm proud of you too, because no one else would have made it.
You're laughing. We could have been swallowed by Hollywood and became like anybody else. We didn't want that. We brought Europe with us to Hollywood.
Who the fuck are you?
And then, when Taiwan wanted to buy our Death Wish 3, we say to the local distributor, sorry, man, you have to take John Cassavetes first, or you don't get Charles Bronson. And now, you know that in Taiwan, they have to see an Altman movie. They have to see Zeffirelli. They will see an opera Otello, because otherwise, they are not going to get Charlie Bronson.
And action!
I came to America being already a quite well-known director in Europe and in Russia. And for 3 years of unemployment, slowly I understood it, that basically no one knew me. I think Pollock introduced me in the bar to Menachem Goldin. I said, this is, you know, this is a young man. Maybe you should talk to him. And Menachem said, come tomorrow morning to my room. So I came to his room.
Oy.
And he was in his underpants, shaving himself. So, okay, tell me the story. I start to tell the story. I was kind of tap dancing, and because it was a Russian story, I placed it in Yugoslavia somewhere. Then he interrupted me. Put the whole story in America, and we're going to do it. Think about it, come back. Before I get my coffee, I already knew that I'm going to do whatever they want just to make a film.
You do what you have to do, and I'll do what I have to do. Whatever happens, happens.
Knock with a big voice, you'd hear him before you got there. John, he says,
He says, this picture has everything. It has a great script. It has a great cast. It has action. It's an unbelievable piece. You have to be schmucks not to make this picture.
When a man walks in at the end of the day and he comes to see how you've done, you ain't gonna look in his eyes. You're gonna look at the floor, because you don't want to see that fear in his eyes when you jump up and grab his face and slam him to the floor.
The nominees for Best Performance by an Actor in a Motion Picture Drama are Harrison Ford in Witness,
Gene Hackman in Twice in a Lifetime,
William Hurt in Kiss of the Spider-Woman, John Voight in Runaway Train,
the winner is John Voight.
Runaway Train, by the Russian director Konchalovsky, is one of three Cannes films chosen for the prestigious Cannes Festival competition. The others are Sam Shepard's Fool for Love and Zeffirelli's film Othello. There are even plans for Jean-Luc Godard to direct King Lear.
It's your name here on the napkin.
Yes, it's
what
me.
What is it?
It's a contract that I have signed the day before yesterday in the afternoon in the bar. We didn't have paper, and this was on the table of the bar, and this is Mr. Jean-Luc Godard. We met, said, hello, Mr. Godard. My first sentence was, what do you want to do with Cannes? And his second question is, what do you want to do with Godard? And I said, let's do a film.
Some guy would come to him and say, I have an idea. Oh, that's a great idea. They'd sign it on a napkin, and that was the deal. They'd call me. And I said, gee, we got to do more than a napkin monocle. No, napkin's good enough. I trust them.
And it was a little bit like a throwback to the original, immigrant fellows who started this business, the moguls, you know. He was a little like that.
Menahem Golan, Yoram Globus, 47 films à Cannes. C'est la société Canon. Canon à Cannes pèse tout simplement 1000 millions de francs pour les 47 films présents.
What kind of satisfaction is there for the two of you to talk to some of the people who maybe would not return the phone call many years ago?
We don't carry any grudge to Hollywood. I mean, definitely not. And we will talk to anybody who didn't talk to us before.
I own you! You've been ducking me for years! You
Let's
got
go.
No chance, you know that? You know that?
Come on, Hawk, back in here now.
Dad, don't let him psych you, Dad! Remember what you told me!
One day, an actor brought me a script which I liked very much about arm wrestling. So I called the lawyer of Stallone. Stallone was getting millions already. So the lawyer says to me, Menachem, you cannot get him. He gets $6 million. So I said to him, I don't want to pay him $6 million. So what do you want? Why are you calling me? I said, I want to pay him 10. The next week, I had a contract.
Other studios put you through a long and contentious development process that, after doing 20 drafts, you may end up with a much better screenplay, or you may end up in development hell, and your movie may never get made. With Cannon, you got an immediate yes or no when you were shooting.
Cannon Films, the home of high-powered, high-voltage motion picture entertainment.
Was not a factory, but it came down to the old way of Hollywood doing films, one after the other. As one was going on, Menachem was working on another one, and another one.
We're Cannon Films, and we're dynamite.
Okay, might as well get rid of the bad news, huh?
What's the bad news?
Okay, it's... Money is yoram.
Yoram was great at finding money. Menachem spent it faster than Yoram could raise it. Were it me, I would have tried to keep Menachem under check and have him not spend. But Yoram was not able or willing to do that.
Menachem is a very stubborn man. When it comes to movies, and he starts something, he does not know who is his wife or daughter or cousin. Nobody.
Heads up, guys. Here comes Colonel Braddock.
So why would a colonel want to go to Cambodia?
Yeah, he could get hurt going across the fence.
He's meeting a recon unit, checking enemy strength.
Clear?
Clear left, sir.
8 years ago, Menachem Golan and his cousin Yoram Globus were virtually unknown outside of Israel. They now run the most powerful independent film company in the world. Golan and Globus control cinema chains in Italy, Germany, and Holland. All in all, they now own more than 1,000 screens in Europe.
In some way, everybody was kind of set with the studio system as it was delivered. And these guys said, why can't we have another one?
They weren't Paramount, but they were right up there really close to that aspect of it. And they were turning out more films than than some studios might make in 10 years. You know?
50 years. There was not a new major. 50, huh? 50 years you did not hear about a new company, a new name. Why? Because Hollywood is very closed, like this. But in the last 3 months, our company made more successes than all the majors of America.
Canon represent, in the last 3 months, 20% of the total box office in America. To understand, I know that many companies and small companies, negotiating and they bid and all of that. If Canon will give a bid, Canon will have it. Canon is mean business, you understand? So it's premature, all of these things. And the rumor that everybody is going after EMI, so it's not even a scoop anymore.
Now it's a fact. The Canon Group knows no bounds. In an unbelievable move, Canon acquires the EMI Library, ABC Screens, and Hell Street Studios practically overnight for no less than $270 million.
When you want to build something, you have to dedicate yourself 100 and more than 100. When you build such a business, somebody gets hurt. And unfortunately, some of my children got hurt. And with all the glamour and the success, there is a sad side to that also.
זו הייתה אימפריה. כולם כינו בי. חיי זוהר, מה את רוצה? אבל זה היה קצת מנוגד לאופי שלי. לא יכולתי להתמזג בזה. אני כל הזמן רציתי לחזור לארץ. המזוודה הייתה מוכנה תמיד. ולא עזר. אז זהו, בסוף אני חזרתי, ומנחם המשיך עם מים שלו.
אני תמיד קיוויתי שלא יקרה כלום ונחזור לגור בארץ, ברור. אף פעם לא רציתי להיות שם באמת. כן.
בעיקר התחושה הייתה כילדה זה שיש לנו אבא קוסם. הוא היה הולך לעשות סרט, או נוסע לחו"ל, חוזר, היו מלא בעיות, הוא היה בא, אין בעיה, הוא היה פותר את הכל. זה היה עד רגע מסוים של התפכחות.
הוא היה מאוד דומיננטי, אבל בפועל הוא לא היה.
קיים החסר. קיים מאוד עוצמתי, אבל בפועל הוא איננו.
אני לא חושב שיש לי כעס. אני לא כועס על אבא שלי על מה שהוא עשה. היו תקופות שכן רציתי שיהיה לי אבא, וכן רציתי שיהיה לי מי לדבר, ולא היה. אני חושב שהבנתי די ברור מה הייעוד שלו ומה הוא עושה עם עצמו. אבא שלי היה נשוי למנחם ולתעשייה, קודם כל. ואנחנו התלווינו.
אני לא יכולתי לסבול את כל מה שקרה. את אבא שלי כבר לא יכולתי לתפוס, הוא היה מאוד 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 רחוק. מאוד 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 גדול, זה כבר היה בלתי אפשרי. כי להיכנס פה לסרטי נוח שיש בהתחלה ארבע חדרים, אחר כך יש שתי קומות, עוד איכשהו, אבל. אחר כך קנון בהוליווד, שאת פשוט נכנס שם לפועיה עם השומר, עם המדים, ואתה גם במפה לא יכול להבין איפה נמצא אבא שלך. לא יכולתי להכיל, להבין, לא יכולתי.
I have hurt my family. It's right that filmmaking, if you devote to it, if you marry this art, it takes away some of your other life, and no question about it.
לא הייתי עצמי, תביני, לא היה לי משפחה, לא כלום. אני...
כשהוא שואל אותי למה לא הגעתי לחייו לפני, אני אומרת לו שזה לא היה מצליח.
זה נכון.
לא חושבת שהיה בכלל מקום לאישה, לילדים, זה הכל היה קולנוע, 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 לא? סרטים, קולנוע, הפקות.
בתי קולנוע.
בתי קולנוע, עסקים.
To celebrate the move to their new headquarters, Golan and Globus invited Hollywood to a black tie party. There were over 2,000 guests.
When I first was asked to come to their office, it was a small little office door. It was kind of dilapidated building. I come back a year later to go to that same little Canon Films, you know, and the little door off of Wilshire. And somebody's coming out and he says, hey, you going across the street? And I go, what do you mean? He goes, look across the street. I look across the street and it's an empire. They built this brand new, huge building and they had a huge party. Bronson was there, Charlie, my hero. They've got Charlie Bronson underneath this roof.
Yoram and me, when we came from Israel and from Europe, we came to Mecca, the Mecca of motion pictures. And we came to pray. And we prayed and prayed. In the beginning, nobody listened. But then we kept on praying. And finally, people begin to listen.
Golan and Globus may sound like a couple of Middle Eastern cities, but they are actually the Israeli cousins who own and operate the Fast Cannon Group. Affectionately and disparagingly known as the Go-Go Boys, they come as close to old-time movie moguls as anyone in the business.
Yes, they are the Go-Go Boys. Innovative. Just like the old moguls came out. They were a replica of those guys.
In Newsweek, they put us on the cover. But you know who gets on the cover? Only heads of governments and presidents, etc. To be on the cover of Newsweek, they call us Go-Go Boys.
They would not think that anything could go wrong. And they kept pushing.
Go, go. It means go, go.
רוצה לדעת על כישלונות.
לא היה לנו כישלונות, אני לא חושב.
אז, אוקיי, אז בוא נדבר על סופרמן. אני מחפשת...
כישלונות.
נכון.
למה?
למה? כי לא יכול להיות, לא יכול להיות, שכל הזמן, בשום חברה בעולם...
מה אכפת לך? מה אכפת לך? מי את שתגידי דבר כזה? מי את? מי את? מה זה נותן לי בסרט דוקומנטרי על הפעילות שלי להשמיע את הכישלונות?
אז בוא אני אגיד לך משהו. זה לא נשמע אמין.
שלא יאמינו.
בוא אני אגיד לך
משהו. למי אני אומר, למי אני צריך...
אז תסתכל לי בעיניים. לא היו לך קשיים?
תשמעי מה שאני אומר לך. כל מה שאת אומרת, את יכולה להגיד. אני לא. למה אני לא יכול להגיד? כי אני לא רוצה לצאת עם דגל של דברים שהם שליליים. לא רוצה. אפילו שהיו, אם היה לי כישלון, אני מוחק אותו. מוחק אותו מחיי. אין. לא היה ולא נברא.
But now to Sylvester Stallone, he who was paid the tidy little sum of $12 million for starring in and helping to write Over the Top at a cost of $40 million. And before the film was released in America, Stallone himself was wondering quite how his fans would respond to the lack of physical violence.
It isn't as raucous or as outrageous as some of the other things I've done, so they might be taken aback.
But Over the Top hasn't gone over particularly well with American audiences. Indeed, it could turn out to be one of Stallone's biggest flops. This news isn't just disturbing for Stallone himself, but also for the man who produced and directed the film. Menachem Golan, head of the rather beleaguered Canon Film Group.
Of course. I know you were involved. Very good.
You're all right?
Yes.
Okay. It's a big honor, Mr. Vice President.
Well, thank you so much.
So you be quiet. It's the Vice President of the United States.
On some level, and I say this now, having run a studio for 10 years, we made 20 movies a year, it isn't a volume business. It's a hits business. You have to make hits in order to survive.
You know, a couple of good movies could have saved them, like anywhere. You know, one big breakout movie or what just didn't happen for them.
Cannon's success was based on cheap movies, but now that's changing. Golan's trying to improve Cannon's image with big-budget movies and running into big problems. With money from the bank, Canon's expanding its empire, buying up movie chains and film distribution rights around the world. And the big debts could be big trouble for Canon.
First, it was little money trouble with a little movie. Then it became big money trouble with bigger movies. You know, like they say, little kids, little problems, big kids, big problems.
Last month, Canon announced a loss of $90 million for the 2 years 1985-86. Down the beach.
The company lost $14 million in the last quarter. Their stock this year has lost 75% of its value, and by mid-December, Canon must raise $18 million to pay off a debt in Britain. Golan has been up and down many times in his life.
I can't be worried because I'm too busy making the movies, and I'm so excited and I'm so into it. I believe that we know what we are doing, and I believe that our future is safe.
When they first got into money trouble, their solution was, let's make more movies. If we can make $1 million a movie and we're running out of money making 20 movies, let's make 30, let's make 40, let's make 50.
That was going so fast, they were making so many films, and they trusted a lot of the agents that were selling them films that should never have been made, that they couldn't give away.
This is some of their advertising. Many films that were not even made, it was all falling apart. And so for me, you know, being part of the family, when they went down, I went down.
We were like a rocket. The success, year after year, we became better and better and more successful, and more successful. And I think when I asked him to stop for 6 months and to reevaluate and just relax, that was the time that he should have listened to me. But he ran like crazy.
As Canon in London planned the launch of Superman 4, here in rehearsal, Golan and Globus must wish more than most that the miraculous rescues of film fantasy might come their way. It could even happen.
Superman, we should put all of our efforts to make from it a hit movie. A better movie than the first three. And because of so many production, you don't have the time to devote to it. This is, for me, our biggest fiasco. It could have been our breakthrough to the top of Hollywood.
Just over 12 months ago, the cousins Menachem Golan and Yoram Globus bought their way into the British filmmaking establishment, but all has not gone as they hoped. In October, their accounting practices came under the scrutiny of the American Securities and Exchange Commission.
The American Securities and Exchange Commission report into their accounting practices is expected this summer. Canon stock is now trading in New York at $4.75 a share. A year ago, they were $45.5.
While investigating this story, Newsnight asked Mr. Golan and Mr. Globus for an interview. But until the SEC report is published, they've decided to remain silent.
I had to deal with it 3 years of my life with the SEC. I used to fly to the States every couple of months to be a witness and to give, to be an investigate. It's very tough. It's very tough. It's very tough when you know that you're completely clean and you have to prove it.
At this point, the company is not able to continue to operate profitably. The movies are not doing well at the box office. I would recommend stockholders and also bondholders that they should, in some form, unite in order to put the company into this kind of a bankruptcy.
Wall Street came and started to think about different way of doing movies. Instead of 5, 10, 3, 70, but 100 million, it became completely different philosophy. That wasn't their philosophy. Their philosophy were craft. I think I left Hollywood because there were no anymore Golan and Globus in Hollywood.
חברת הסרטים קנון של מנחם גולן ויורם גלובוס נקלעה לקשיים השנה. זו לא הפעם הראשונה שמנחם גולן נמצא במשבר, ובמובן הכלכלי של המילה, הפעם יש לו מאיפה ליפול. הוא קם, הוא יקום, כך הוא מבטיח, הערב הוא כאן, ערב טוב מנחם וחג שמח.
חג שמח. חג
שמח. לפני שנה, ברעיון עיתונאי בארץ, כשהעריכו את החברה שלך ב-500 מיליון דולר, אתה אמרת, חברה כמו שלנו לא יכולה ליפול. אז איפה טעית?
לא טעיתי, לא נפלנו. ראשית, הטעות הייתה שלא העריכו את החברה נכון. החברה מעורכת כיום בביליון 200 מיליון דולר. אז כך שמסכום כזה קשה מאוד ליפול. היו בעיות, כי ניסינו לבלוע חברה אנגלית, חברת EMI, ניסינו לבלוע דג יותר מדי שמן בשבילנו, ופתאום נשארנו תקועים בדצמבר שנה שעברה עם תשלום שהיינו צריכים לבצע. אתה יודע, הגאווה לא להיכשל.
איזה גודל של תשלום?
לא כל כך גדול, 75 מיליון דולר.
אמרת לא כל כך גדול, וחשבתי למה לא התקשרת אליי.
על כל פנים, אמא שלי אמרה לי בילדותי, יזרקו אותך מהדלת, תחזור מהחלון, יש חלונות, תודה לאל.
Just a month ago, the Canon Titanic had a $200 million debt and was about to go under. But now it seems Golan and Globus have one more lifeboat in reserve. Giancarlo Peretti of Pathé Pictures is the shiny new partner of this unstoppable Israeli duo.
Moretti was a guy who showed up in town and he was representing a lot of money and he got into the company and bought the company. I don't know. In my mind, this was part of the end of Cannon.
מה שגמר את השותפות הזו זה היה הרצון העצום של מנחם להיות חופשי ולעשות קולנוע וסרטים ללא הגבלה. שלא יהיה דירקטוריון ושלא תהיה אישי ועדה ושלא יגידו לו כן ושלא יגידו לו לא. וכאשר פרטי ויורם ניסו לעצור את מנחם, זה לא היה לרוחו. הוא בן אדם שהוא לא ניתן לעצירה.
מנחם היה מתחייב התחייבויות בלתי רגילות, ולא עניין אותו מאיפה, את הכסף שישיג יורם. ויורם כל הזמן היה צריך, אתה יודע, איכשהו הגיע רגע שהוא אמר, הוא לא רצה לתת למנחם יותר יד חופשית להחליט מה שהוא רוצה.
We had an empire. We had a company that created an empire. But then some powers which are more belonging to the world of numbers, mathematics, money. They took away Yoram from me.
I really collapsed because it's like running after money all the time and to finish, as you know, the 45 movies cost almost $1 billion. $1 billion, it's a lot of money. And to finish the movie, I had to run, and I didn't want to do it all my life. Menachem, we tried to stop him, so he wanted to leave. And I told him, I'm not going with you.
This was the last straw. But the whole thing was, I think, the difference of philosophy of motion pictures. He wanted to buy cinemas, I wanted to make movies. I couldn't stay, couldn't take it. And I told Yoram, a divorce is a divorce is a divorce. And we divorced. In Rome it was. Yoram brought his lawyers, his friends, I was there alone. They all tried to convince me to take a vacation, to forget it, but I was so hurt that I couldn't come back to the people who ruined Cannon.
This was like my home, you know, and at some point, Yoram and Menachem were like my parents, and they split. So it was like when your parents are getting divorced or something.
He said, divorce is till the end. And I paid him, of his share, $15 million, which was a lot. And I got him 25 from Cannon, so it's 40 million. And I arranged for him a line of credit of $35 million. So he had $75 million. And he said to me, I will teach you how I'm doing doubles in Cannon.
Why do you choose Cannes for your main launch of the new company?
Well, Cannes is my New Year, my Christmas. I count my years from Cannes to Cannes.
The industry will have great difficulty coping with you on your own without your cousin, because you've been together, I think, about 30 years.
That's right. Well, a divorce is a divorce, and you get used to it. And you find that life offers you a way to go on. And now, for me, it's the dawn of the 21st century, my new company.
En revanche, Hollywood n'est plus ce qu'il était. Columbia a déjà été racheté par les Japonais de Sony. Eh bien, cette fois, c'est un groupe européen qui attaque. Pathé veut racheter la MGM, la fameuse métro Goldwyn-Mayer, celle du Lion. Waouh !
À l'occasion d'une fusion historique, Canon Pathé, dirigé par l'inarrêtable Giancarlo Paretti et Yoram Globus, ont pris le contrôle des studios MGM pour la somme incroyable de 1,3 milliard de dollars.
Non mais, il fait une aide.
1 milliard 350 millions de dollars.
1 milliard 360 millions de dollars. Pas mal.
על כרטיס הביקור הזה שאני מחזיק בידי מודפס האריה השואג, סמלה המפורסם של חברת מטרו גולדווין מאייר. אם תתבוננו היטב תראו שמתחת למלטאותיו של האריה הזה מודפס באותיות אדומות יורם גלובוס, President and Chief Operating Officer.
אתה היית מעלה על דעתך שנשיא MGM יקראו לו יורם?
בכלל לא דיברנו על הפרידה הטראגית, אפשר לומר, בינך לבין מנחם גולן.
איך שאני רואה את זה, הסימבול של החברה שלנו הוא אריה. מנחם הוא אריה קולנוע, אריה אוהב חופש, ומנחם בחר להיות חופשי. ואני משוכנע שהוא יצליח.
אבל למרות הדברים החמים האלה, אתם אינכם משוחחים זה עם זה.
בכל משפחה עובר איזה חתול שחור, ואני משוכנע שאנחנו... הוא בירך אותי על התמנותי כנשיא MGM. ואני משוכנע שאנחנו נחזור, אם מנחם יבוא עם פרויקט שיתאים למטרו גולדווין מאייר, אני משוכנע שאנחנו נקבל את זה.
Comment éviter Menahem Golan? Il est partout, inépuisable malgré ses 63 ans. Charmeur, colérique, bricoleur de films et véritable négociateur. Depuis quelques mois, il a perdu le soutien des banques, sans argent ou presque. Il a quand même réussi à produire 8 films cette année.
Menahem went on and he tried to make a go of it. And it wasn't the same.
Ready?
Take two.
The whole thing should be Speedy Gonzalez. Fast, fast, fast.
Parker.
I'm starving and there's no food for me here. What do I do?
This crew is going to have lunch today at 2 o'clock at that location. Fine. Okay. How are we going to do that?
It's 12:15.
Without killing them to get them back.
12:15 is nice.
Yes. So you're telling me there's enough time?
Yes.
So we got
to
do it.
If you don't talk to me now, we shall shoot over it.
Let's go. Let's move this stuff to the.
No, it's not close.
One thing which I really dislike is that people here give more attention to the lunches and off time than to the time they work. Everybody's worried to, what about the lunch? From the start of the morning, I don't hear anything else but about lunch.
I didn't have the power that I should have had when I had Yoram. I didn't have that half of me. I was working with only my left hand and not my right. I made a mistake, and it took me some difficult years, but I kept on doing movies. I never stopped.
MGM faisait l'objet d'un mandat d'arrêt international de la part des États-Unis qui ont demandé son extradition.
In a shocking turn of events, MGM chairman Giancarlo Paretti is accused of fraud and money laundering for the Italian mafia.
I'm a believer in Yoram. I believe that he believed that Paretti actually had money, whereas in actuality Paretti was cooking the books.
L'Italien qui fait payer Hollywood avec de l'argent français Giancarlo Paretti a été arrêté à Los Angeles. Paretti était l'ancien partenaire du Crédit Lyonnais dans le rachat de la MGM. Il a été interpellé à la demande de la justice française. Le Crédit Lyonnais lui réclame un demi-milliard de dollars.
It was very difficult for me to accept it, what's happening, but it was the real life and I couldn't do nothing when everything is suddenly starting to fall on you, and you are leaving because you don't want to be there, it hurts. It hurts very much. I quit from the company. I decided I'm out. And then I decided I'm coming back to Israel. After leaving MGM, I had to start all over again. So I began to work on a new dream, building a real Hollywood studio between Jerusalem and Tel Aviv.
כדאי שכולכם תיקחו בחשבון שכל עוד אנחנו חיים, אנחנו צריכים להיות מאושרים. המוות משעמם. משפט טוב. Then I decided where I can make movies. I go back to the place and I went back to Israel where I can make movies. And that's what I'm doing all the time.
יש לי תסריטים אחד אחד בלי סוף, טובים מאוד. יש לי סדרה טלוויזיונית. את רואה את זה? תראי איזה גודל. האגדה לבית זייד. יש לי תסריט שגמרתי שנקרא הגולם, על הגולם מפראג. זה סרט שאני מתעתד, כבר התחלתי לעניין באפריקה. זה המשך מכרות המלך שלמה. אחר כך יש לי קומדיה ישראלית בשם אשתי אהובתי, שהיא כתובה בעברית ובאנגלית, I love my wife. שמשעמם לי, אני מנסה למצוא דרכים לממן סרטים. מי אמר שאי אפשר להרוויח כסף בהשקעה קטנה בסרט ישראלי? קחו לדוגמה את הסרטים של גולן גלובוס. קחו את אלדורדו, את קזבלן, סלח שבתי. כולם הרוויחו כסף. הבמאי מנחם גולן, חתן פרס ישראל, מועמד לאוסקר האמריקאי ולגלובוס הזהב, מכריז בזה על מבצע מיוחד ומרתק. מבצע שיתוף הקהל הרחב באפשרות השקעה במימון סרט חדש. ואני גומר במשפט גדול, כל הקודם זוכה.
כל יום מחדש אני מתרגש לבוא הנה. אני חושב שזה מקום יפהפה. וזה גם גאוות יחידה, כמו שאומרים. ועברתי שנים לא קלות, שלא תבינו לא טוב. המשרדים פה שאתם רואים, כלב, לא יכולתי להזכיר לכלב, לא לבן אדם. כלב לא רצה להיות פה, פחד להיות פה. היום אין מקום, אין מטר אחד פנוי. מי חלם בכלל שיהיה פה אולפנים, שבישראל יעשו סרטים, מי חלם? אנחנו חלמנו.
אתה כועס עדיין?
Of course. We lost 20 years. Who could have been Columbia, MGM, Universal? Who are they? We could be better than them. It's a waste of talent. And now I have a script that I foresee that will bring us to the top.
Alan. My name.
אני מספר את הסיפור, איך נסענו לאמריקה.
יש לי היום פשוט אורחים מפארמונט. אז באים מפארמונט, מגיעים שניים. אז אני צריך להיות איתם.
כן.
ויש לי עוד אורח מאמריקה, אבל יש מה לדבר. בשבוע הבא אני אתפנה, אנחנו...
יש לי תסריט ששנינו עומדים באוסקר ולוקחים אותו. האמריקאי. האוסקר האמריקאי. תזכור שאמרתי לך, זה הכל. תזכור שאמרתי לך את זה. יורם. פעם אחת בחיים, תקרא את הסריט.
בסדר, נו, בסדר, טוב.
תקרא לי את הסריט. תעשה קולנוע. קולנוע צריך לעשות, שם הרווחנו את כל הכסף. זה היה טוב. הקומבינציה של שנינו הייתה נפלאה. עשינו קולנוע אמריקאי, קולנוע בינלאומי, זכינו בפרסים. חבל. יאללה, נמשיך.
אתה נמצא
ביפו, אתה נמצא ביפו, אתה נמצא ביפו, יפו, יפו, יפו.
יפתי.
יפתי.
איזה יופי.
פורטונה, אוי, 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 אוי.
הנה ראונה, הייתה פורטונה. אתה זוכר?
כן. זה הסרט, סרט נומרו אונו.
שבא סיבור הדייקות, מלצר חמדה, שקטינו. זה כבר מול פייסבון יראה. חפורה שלי, אני יראה.
סרט הזה הגיע אוסקר. פח, זה דבר זה.
גברת סטלה,
סקינה.
לא, לא, באמת שלא,
באמת שלא. תבוא לבקר את דודה סטלה,
תבוא. אני מגמרת.
איזה תענוג זה לראות סרטים, אה? זה רץ כל כך מהר אז, שלא הספקנו ליהנות. אני רואה את זה עכשיו, אני אומר, זה תענוג. למה אז לא עשינו את זה קצת סטופ וליהנות מזה וליהנות מהעשייה?
הלך בממשלה. געגוע, געגוע, זה הכל. בימים האלה.
לעשות עוד 49 סרטים.
לא, 49, אבל לפחות ארבע. לפחות ארבע.